Good morning, students. Welcome back to English class. Students, today we are going to see two new chapters in grammar part. One is collective nouns and another one is abstract nouns. So, all of you be ready with your English grammar book and a pencil. Students, before going to the concept, let us recall about nouns and its types. Okay, students. What do you mean by a noun? A noun is a naming word. What do you mean by noun? A noun is a naming word given to a person, place, animal, thing, and feeling. Okay, students. Let's discuss about types of nouns. How many types of nouns are there? There are 8 types of nouns are there. The most important 8 types are common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, gender noun, and possessive noun. We have seen common noun and proper noun in detail. Okay, students, what do you mean by common noun? Common noun, common name of a place, common name of a person, common name of an animal, or common name of a thing. It is a common name given to a person, place, animal, and thing. Okay, students, then what about proper noun? A proper noun is a specific name. It is a specific or particular name given to a person, place, or animal. Okay, students, now we are going to see about collective nouns. What do you mean by collective noun? Already we have learned that noun means naming word. What do you mean by noun? Noun means naming word. Then what is the meaning for the word collective? It means collection or group. Okay, students, now tell me, what do you mean by collective noun? Collective noun is a noun used to give a name for a group of people, group of animals, or group of things. What do you mean by collective noun? Collective noun used to name a group of persons, group of animals, or group of things. It is known as collective noun. Okay, students, look at the given example. A team of players. A team of players. Students, in this example, the noun team. It means the collective noun team. Team is a collective noun which refers a group of players. And students, collective noun does not begin with a capital letter. It always starts with a small letter, not capital letter. It always begin with a small letter. Students, here are some examples of collective nouns used for people. Okay, students, look at the first example, that is a troop of dancers. A troop of dancers. Students, in this example, troop is a collective noun which refers a group of dancers. Troop is a collective noun which refers group of dancers. Okay, students, let's move to the next example, that is a gang of robbers. A gang of robbers. In this example, gang is a collective noun. Gang is a collective noun which refers group of robbers. Students, look at the given example. A crowd of people. A crowd of people. In this example, crowd is a collective noun. Crowd is a collective noun which refers group of people. Crowd is a collective noun which refers group of people. Let's move to the next example, that is a crew of sailors. A crew of sailors. In this example, crew is a collective noun which refers group of sailors. A crew of sailors. In this example, crew is a collective noun which refers group of sailors. Students, look at the first example, that is a team of players. The given example is a team of players. In this example, team is a collective noun which refers group of players. Team is a collective noun which refers group of players. Let's move to the next example. A band of musicians. A band of musicians. In this example, band is a collective noun which refers group of musicians. Okay, students, once again I'm repeating. The given examples are a team of players and a band of musicians. In the first example, team is a collective noun which refers group of players. In the second example, band is a collective noun which refers group of musicians. Students, let us see some more examples of collective nouns used for animals. Okay, students, look at the first example, that is a brood of chickens. A brood of chickens. In this example, brood is a collective noun which refers group of chickens. Brood is a collective noun which refers group of chickens. Let's move to the next example, that is a school of fish. A school of fish. School is a collective noun which refers group of fish. Which refers group of fish. Students, two examples are given. The first one is a brood of chickens and the second one is a school of fish. In the first example, brood is a collective noun which refers group of chickens. In the second example, a school of fish. School is a collective noun which refers group of fish. Students, let us see the third example. The given third example is a litter of puppies. A litter of puppies. In this example, litter is a collective noun which refers group of puppies. Puppies mean baby dogs, okay? A litter of puppies. Litter is a collective noun which refers group of puppies. Let's move to the next example, that is a pride of lions. A pride of lions. In this example, pride is a collective noun which refers group of lions. Students, the given two examples are a litter of puppies and a pride of lions. In the third example, litter is a collective noun which refers group of puppies. In the fourth example, pride is a collective noun which refers group of lions. Students, the given example is a pack of wolves. In this example, pack is a collective noun which refers group of wolves. Let's move to the next example, that is a troop of monkeys. What is the given example? That is a troop of monkeys. In this example, troop is a collective noun which refers group of monkeys. Students, two examples are given. One is a pack of wolves and the next one is a troop of monkeys. In the fifth example, pack is a collective noun which refers a group of wolves. And the sixth example is a troop of monkeys. In this example, troop is a collective noun which refers group of monkeys. Students, let us see some more examples of collective nouns used for things. Okay, students, look at the first example, a pack of cards. The given example is a pack of cards. In this example, pack is a collective noun which refers group of cards. Pack is a collective noun which refers group of cards. Let's move to the next one, that is an album of photos. An album of photos. Album is a collective noun which refers group of photos. Students, two examples are given. The first one is a pack of cards and the second one is an album of photos. In the first example, pack is a collective noun which refers group of cards. In the second example, album is a collective noun which refers group of photos. Students, let us see the third example. The third example is a bouquet of flowers. A bouquet of flowers. Bouquet is a collective noun which refers group of flowers. Let's move to the next example, that is a bunch of keys. A bunch of keys. Students, bunch is a collective noun which refers group of keys. Bunch is a collective noun which refers group of keys. Okay, students, two examples are given. The given third example is a bouquet of flowers. In the third example, bouquet is a collective noun which refers group of flowers. In the fourth example, bunch is a collective noun which refers group of keys. Bunch is not only used for keys, but also it is used for grapes and banana also. Students, let us see the next example, that is a bundle of sticks. The given example is a bundle of sticks. In this example, bundle is a collective noun which refers group of sticks. Let us move to the next one, that is a fleet of ships. The given example is a fleet of ships. In this example, fleet is a collective noun which refers group of ships. Students, two examples are given. The given fifth example is a bundle of sticks. In the fifth example, bundle is a collective noun which refers group of sticks. The sixth example is a fleet of ships. In the sixth example, fleet is a collective noun which refers group of ships. Students, let us see some more examples. Look at the given example. Look at the first example, that is a fleet of ships is entering the harbor. A fleet of ships is entering the harbor. Students, in this example, fleet is a collective noun which refers group of ships. Already we have learned this collective noun. So students, fleet is a collective noun which refers group of ships. Let us move to the next example, that is a swarm of bees is buzzing around the flowers. A swarm of bees is buzzing around the flowers. Students, in this sentence, swarm is a collective noun. Swarm is a collective noun which refers group of bees. Group of bees is known as swarm. So swarm is a collective noun which refers group of bees. Students, in the first example, fleet is a fleet of ships is entering the harbor. In this sentence, fleet is a collective noun which refers group of ships. In the second example, a swarm of bees is buzzing around the flowers. In this example, swarm is a collective noun which refers group of bees. Students, let us see the third example. That is, there is a flock of sheep. There is a flock of sheep. In this sentence, flock is a collective noun which refers group of sheep. Okay, students, let's move to the next example. That is, she has a big dog and a litter of kittens. She has a big dog and a litter of kittens. Students, already we have learned litter. We have learned the collective noun litter. So students, litter is not only used for puppies, but also it is used for kittens. In this sentence, litter is a collective noun which refers group of kittens. So students, again and again I am repeating, litter is a collective noun. The collective noun litter is not only used for puppies, but also used for kittens. Kittens mean baby cats. Okay, once again I am repeating. Look at the third example. In this sentence, flock is a collective noun which refers group of sheep. In the fourth example, she has a big dog and a litter of kittens. In this sentence, litter is a collective noun which refers group of kittens. Students, let's do the first exercise, that is fill in the blanks with appropriate words. Students, in this exercise, one helping box is also given. Some collective nouns are given inside the helping box. Let us see what are the collective nouns are there inside the box. Band, bunch, pack, flock and class. These five collective nouns are given inside the box. Okay, students, and along with this helping box, some sentences are also given. Students, before going to do any exercise, you should do one thing. One is read the title properly and read the given sentences properly. Okay, students, look at the first one. A dash of wolves howled in the jungle. So, students, which collective noun is suitable for the first one? Now, look inside the helping box. Band is the correct answer for the first one? No. Bunch is the correct answer for the first one? No. Pack is the correct answer for the first one? Yes, you are right. Because pack is a collective noun which refers group of wolves, otherwise group of cats. So students, in this sentence, pack is the correct answer. The first answer is pack. A pack of wolves howled in the jungle. Let's move to the second one. A dash of musicians sang at the party. Okay, students, now four collective nouns are there. Which one is suitable for the second one? The first one is band. Band is the correct answer for the second one? Yes, you're right. Band is the correct answer for the second one because band is a collective noun which refers group of musicians. So, students, the second answer is band. Let's move to the third one. A dash of sheep is crossing the road. A dash of sheep is crossing the road. Students, remaining three collective nouns are there. Which one is suitable for the third one? I mean, which one is correct? Bunch is the correct answer for the third one? No. Flock is the correct answer for the third one? Yes. Already we have learned that flock is a collective noun which refers group of sheep. So students, the third answer is flock. Let's move to the fourth one. Where did you last see the dash of keys? Where did you last see the dash of keys? So students, remaining two collective nouns are there. One is bunch and another one is class. So which one is correct for the fourth one? Yes, you're right. Bunch is the correct answer for the fourth one because bunch is a collective noun which refers group of keys or a group of grapes or bananas. So the answer for the fourth one is bunch. Students, remaining the first four sentences are completed. Remaining few are there. You should try in your grammar book. Then only you can easily understand this concept. Students, now we are going to do the next exercise, that is tick the correct collective nouns. Students, here some collective nouns are given. Some are right and some are wrong. What you want to do means you have to read the heading properly and read the collective nouns properly and then answer. If the given collective noun is correct, you put a tick mark. If it is wrong, you put cross mark and write the correct answer for that. Okay, students, let us see the first one. A band of monkeys. Is it right? A band of monkeys. Is this right? Students, is this right? No, it is wrong. So what do you want to do? just put a cross mark and write the answer. So students, we know very well that band is a collective noun, but it refers group of musicians. Okay, and monkeys. For monkeys, what collective noun is used for monkeys? Group of monkeys is known as troop. So students, you can write answer as a band of musicians or a troop of monkeys. You can write any one answer. Okay students, let's move to the next one. A pile of stones. The given collective noun is a pile of stones. Is it right? No, it is also wrong collective noun, because a pile is a collective noun which refers group of books, not stones. So this is wrong. So now what do you want to do? Put a cross mark and write the correct answer for the second one. So students, pile is a collective noun which refers group of books. So students, you can write pile of books. The correct answer is a pile of books. Let's move to the third one. A group of grapes. Students, is this right? No, it is also wrong. So put a cross mark and write the correct answer. Students, what is the collective noun for group grapes? Yes, you are right. The correct answer is a bunch of grapes. So students, the answer for the third one is a bunch of grapes. Before writing the answer, put a cross mark and then write the answer in pencil. Let's move to the fourth one. A bouquet of flowers. Is this right? Yes, the fourth, the given fourth one is right. So just you put a tick mark. No need to do anything because it is the right answer. So just put a tick mark. Let's move to the fifth one. A school of elephants. A school of elephants. Students, is this right answer? No, this is also wrong. So put a cross mark and write the correct answer for the fifth one. Students, already we have learned that school is a collective noun which refers group of fish. Okay, group of fish is known as school. So students, and a group of elephants is known as herd. Herd of elephants. So students, you can write either a school of fish or herd of elephants. Students, the first five are completed. Remaining few collective nouns are there in your grammar book. You should try in your book and use pencil. Students, now we are going to learn about abstract nouns. Students, already we learned that noun is a naming word given to a person, place, animal, thing. So we can see, we can touch, we can hear. But abstract nouns are not like that. We cannot see, we cannot taste, we cannot touch, we cannot hear, we cannot taste. So students, abstract nouns or abstract noun is the name of an action, quality or state. Just we can think of that, we can feel of that. But we cannot see, we cannot touch, we cannot taste, we cannot hear. Students, now we are going to see about abstract nouns in detail. Students, already we have learned that noun is a naming word given to a person, place, animal or thing. Students, these, we can see these things. Okay, we can see the person. We can touch the person, but in abstract nouns, the things are not like that. We cannot see them, we cannot touch them, we cannot hear them. So just we can think of them, we can feel of them. So students, abstract noun is the name of an action, quality or emotions. What do you mean by abstract noun? It is the name given for an action, quality or emotion. Emotion means feeling. For example, happy, joy, sadness, etc. Students, some examples are given here. Let us see. Look at the first one, laughter. It is an action. So laughter is an action. Let's move to the next one, that is bravery. It is it comes under the category quality. So it is also perfect example for abstract noun. Let's move to the third one, sad. So it is an emotion. Emotion means, already I told that it is a feel. So students, name of an action, name of a quality, or name of an emotion is known as abstract nouns. We cannot see that, we cannot touch, we cannot hear, we cannot smell, but we can think of that and we can feel of that. Students, now we are going to see an example. Look at the given example. The cookie brought joy to the toddler. The cookie brought joy to the toddler. Students, already we have learned that nouns can be seen, touched, but abstract nouns are not like that. We can't see them, we cannot touch them, or we cannot smell them. So students, in this example sentence, we can see the cookie. We can see the cookie, and we can see the toddler also, because these two are nouns. These two are nouns. Because the cookie comes under the category thing, and a toddler. Toddler means a small baby. It may be girl baby or boy baby. It's a baby. Okay, a toddler comes under the category person. So two nouns are there, we can see them. But joy is not like that. We can feel, it is an emotion, we can feel that. So students, joy is an abstract noun. Students, now we are going to do the first exercise, that is circle the abstract nouns. Students, some nouns are given here. Some are abstract nouns, some are not abstract nouns. So what do you want to do? You should read the nouns properly and then answer. Okay students, let us read the words: cake, youth, potato, curry, joy, stool, cleverness, and actor. Okay, these are the nouns given here. What do you want to do? Read it again and answer it properly. If the given word is abstract noun, you have to circle the word. If the given word is not an abstract noun, no need to circle. Just skip the word and move to the next word. Okay, let us see. The first word is cake. Is cake an abstract noun? No, it is not an abstract noun, because we can see the cake and we can touch the cake. So it is not an abstract noun. So students, no need to do anything, just skip the word and move to the next word, that is youth. Students, is youth an abstract noun? Yes, youth is an abstract noun. So students, what do you want to do? You have to circle the noun youth. Use pencil, okay? No need to use any pen or any ink pen. Just use pencil to circle the abstract noun. Let's move to the third word, that is potato. Is potato an abstract noun? No, it is not an abstract noun, because we can see that potato, we can see and we can touch. So potato is not an abstract noun. So students, no need to do anything. Move to the next word, that is Kareem. Students, is Kareem an abstract noun? No, it is also not an abstract noun, because Kareem is a proper noun. It is a particular name of a person. So it is not an abstract noun. Let's move to the next word, that is joy. Students, is joy an abstract noun? Yes, it is an abstract noun, because we cannot see them. We cannot see the joy, but we can feel. It is an emotion. So students, circle the abstract noun joy. Let's move to the next word, that is stool. Is stool an abstract noun? No, it is not an abstract noun, because stool comes under the category thing. We can see, we can touch. So stool is not an abstract noun. No need to do anything. Let's move to the next word, that is cleverness. Is cleverness an abstract noun? Yes, it is an abstract noun because it is a quality. It is a quality of a person. So students, cleverness is an abstract noun. We have to circle. Let's move to the last word, that is actor. Is actor an abstract noun? No, it is not an abstract noun because actor is a common noun of a person. We can see that person, we can touch that person. So actor is not an abstract noun. No need to do anything. Students, here we have done few words. Remaining few words are there in your grammar book. So read the words properly, read the nouns properly and do it yourself with pencil. Students, now we are going to do the second exercise, that is fill in the blanks with these abstract nouns. Students, in this exercise also one helping box is given. Some abstract nouns are given inside the box. Let us see what are they. The words are, the abstract nouns are greed, childhood, slyness, kindness, honesty. Students, greed means selfish desire. What is the meaning for the word greed? It means selfish desire. Childhood means we can experience our childhood days. Slyness means being smart or cunning. It is a quality. Kindness, it is also quality of being kind to others. Honesty, it is also quality. Okay students, two sentences are given here. One is, let us read the first one. I want to say one thing to you. Before doing any exercise, you should read the heading properly and read the sentence properly. Okay, now I am going to read the first one. That is, Kishore showed dash to the sick animal. Kishore showed dash to the sick animal. Students, you have to choose any one from the given box. Greed is the answer? No. Childhood? No. Slyness? No. And the fourth one is kindness. Yes, kindness is the correct answer for the first one. Kishore showed kindness to the sick animal. Okay students, let's do the second one. The fox fooled the lion with his dash. The fox fooled the lion with his dash. Students, remaining four abstract nouns are there. You can choose any one of these four. Greed is the correct answer? No. Childhood? No. Slyness? Yes, because what I told, slyness is the quality of being smart or cunning. So slyness is the correct answer for the second one. The fox fooled the lion with his slyness. Students, we have completed the first two sentences. Remaining three are there. You should try in your grammar book. Then only you can easily understand the concept. And if you practice this exercise, you can easily understand. Okay students, now we are going to do the third exercise, that is underline the abstract nouns in the following sentences. Okay students, some sentences are given. You should read the sentences properly and then underline the abstract nouns. Underline the abstract nouns. Let us see the first one. My mother asked me not to get into trouble. My mother asked me not to get into trouble. Okay students, now find out the abstract noun in the first sentence. What is the abstract noun given here? Yes, you are right. The abstract noun is trouble. Students, already we learned that abstract noun is the name of an action, quality or emotion. We can think of them and we can feel of them. We can't see, we can't touch, or we cannot taste or smell it. Okay, in the given first sentence, the abstract noun is trouble. Okay, now what do you want to do? You have to underline the noun trouble. Okay, students, the first one is done for you. Remaining 6 or 7 sentences are there in your grammar book. You should read it properly and then answer. Use pencil, not pen or any refill. Okay, students, now we came to an end. That means recap corner. Today we have seen 2 new topics in grammar part. One is collective nouns and another one is abstract nouns. Students, what do you mean by collective nouns? Before that, let me explain about nouns, okay? Noun is a naming word given to a person, place, animal or thing. Then, what do you mean by collective noun? A collective noun is a noun used to name a group of persons, group of animals or group of things. For example, a team of players. In this example, team is a collective noun which refers group of players. So group of players is known as a team. Okay, students, and one more thing, a collective noun usually takes a singular verb in a sentence. Okay, in a sentence, collective noun takes a singular verb. And one more thing, collective nouns always begin with a small letter, not a capital letter. Okay, now let me explain about abstract noun. What do you mean by abstract noun? Abstract noun is the name given for a name of a quality, action, emotion or state. It refers to things we can think of that or we can feel of that. We can't see, we can't touch, we can't smell or we cannot taste of it. So abstract noun is the name of a quality, action or state. Students, today we have seen 2 new chapters in grammar part. One is collective nouns and another one is abstract nouns. I hope you understood clearly. Students, you should practice the exercises in your grammar book. Then only you can easily understand the concepts. Without practicing the exercises, you can't understand. Use pencil in your grammar book. Don't use any pen or a refill in your grammar book. Write the answers clearly, properly and neatly. Students, we will meet on next class with another topic. Thank you.